This topic of understanding who we are, there's still a challenge. The challenge is, how can I be a God and I'm passing through all these wahala, all these problems? Is it really possible? Is this, some people are kind of feeling that yes, I might just be God's creation, Sha, but me being a God, it's too hard for me to comprehend. We're gods on earth because we possess the DNA. He created us, therefore we're gods. Now, I understand for some of us, it may be a bit challenging to accept this. I'm going to help you to connect to your God nature this morning. I will guide you. You will do the connection, but I will guide you. Now, once you might cry in the process, but that's okay. If you want to cry, cry if you have to. But first of all, forgive yourself. You have to forgive yourself, forgive your past, right? And open yourself. You will feel the God nature in you. Knowledge begins to bring it out, okay? Knowledge begins to solidify that belief. But remember, have no doubt that you're a God. Do not fear that you're a God. Fear and doubt doesn't work with God. You shall not please me without faith. Then once you make sure that in whatever you're doing this year on a daily basis, try as much as you can to eliminate selfishness from the grand operation of anything you do. If you say, I'm not doing this business, is it coming from a selfish point of view? No matter how you explain it. For instance, you have downlines in your business, right? And you want to quit the business. If truly you're operating in the God DNA in you, you first of all think about how will they survive? You first of all think about your downlines. What would happen to them before you make that decision? If every decision you're making is in the betterment of others, that is a God in you working. But the devil is selfish. He's always thinking about himself. Yes. And that is why you disconnect from your God DNA the moment you begin to always and only think about yourself, 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 yourself. That's when you disconnect. I'm not saying you shouldn't take care of yourself. I'm not saying you shouldn't build yourself, right? But I'm talking about in the grand scheme of things, all you're thinking about is yourself, yourself, yourself. You are disconnecting from the God nature, and you can't operate in the God nature in you. You can't. But I'm going to help a couple of you who are still hesitant. You are still doubting, am I really a God? All right. Now I'm going to play a song. I'm going to guide you into that space this morning. And some of you are going to feel it. Like I said, probably you might probably feel like crying, but that's okay. Even if you do cry, as long as you enter into the essence of your God nature. So I'm going to share my screen now. And it's a very simple exercise. Now, somebody actually told me that, look, Ambassador, you say you can connect me to my God nature. How now? In 2, 3 minutes. Yes, in 2, 3 minutes. Max 4 minutes. He says, it can't be possible. I mean, a whole God nature, you want to connect me in 2, 3 minutes. I said, hold on a second. I said, it will be difficult if I was going to infuse it inside you. It's already inside you. The God DNA is inside it, just for me to direct you there. That's all. Just connect. So why should it take time? It's already there inside you. When it will be difficult is if I'm going to, I'm saying I want to recreate it inside you. I want to find a way to infuse it inside you. But it's already inside you. So why should it take time? Should it take time? 2-3 minutes. You connect. I'm going to help you do that now. At this point, you can close your eyes. This is going to be a point of bliss, a point of connection. See, you may have gone through series of bad influences, bad decisions. I want you to forgive yourself this morning. You've made mistakes, yes. You've disconnected through selfishness, yes. But forgive yourself. You were not created to be a wanderer on earth. You were created for a purpose. God's DNA runs through your veins. God is a God of purpose. Therefore, you are on earth for a powerful purpose. Today, forgive yourself. Forgive anybody who has done wrong to you. Let them go. Forgive them from inside of you, truly. Let them go. It is not in your place to be burdened with that heavy weight. Let them go. Forgive your father. Forgive your mother. Forgive them that wronged you. Also find it in your heart to forgive those that you wronged. Say in your heart, I'm sorry. For those you have wronged, say in your heart, I'm sorry. You will make amends in time, but say, I'm sorry. At this time, I now want you to imagine, just imagine for a second, what if God actually created you? What if God Almighty, the King of Kings, the Creator of the universe, actually created you? What can stop you? What is it you cannot do? Think about it for a second. For the fact you can imagine the magnitude of the things you can do if God created you is a simple evidence that God is in you. Dogs cannot imagine. Fish cannot imagine. Animals cannot imagine because they don't possess the DNA of God. Only you and I can imagine. We can be creative. And only God can create. Therefore, God resides in you. Simply connect to the God DNA in you. See the wonders you can do on earth. See the power deposited in you. See the challenges you're crushing left, right, and center and providing solutions. See how powerful you are. Feel God speaking to you and saying, my son, my daughter, as he is descending right by your side and smiling towards you. And whispering in your ears, "My son, my daughter, go ye into the world and multiply, subdue, dominate, and prosper." It is a mandate that God Almighty has given you and I, and He's saying it again to you. With all power and dominion released to you to succeed. Therefore, you are powerful. You cannot fail. Yes, you cannot fail, because you have not been designed to fail. All the forces to help you to achieve your God-given goal on earth begins to come to you this morning. It will continually come to you as you begin to execute all the goals and plans that you have as your desire. For God will give us the desires of our heart. He said it, the desires of our heart, because He is in direct communication with us, because He is in us. Do not have no doubt. Do not have no fear. Do not have no doubt. Do not have no fear. This is the beginning of a new you. God bless all of you, because you've stepped into your new nature, the nature of the Godhead in you, where prosperity, abundance, fulfillment, impact is. You are a child of God. You are a God on earth. Don't let anybody tell you otherwise. Now arise. God bless you.